Hello, this is Ultra Norm from the Ultra Tourist. Come to you live. This is Shark Runner 17, aka my wife. We're off to the Mozart 100. Oof, a couple of days. Which takes place, when is it? The 15th?
15th of June.
And we figure we'll go over our gear, which we're going to be wearing for this 120K, is it? Where the hills will be alive in Salzburg?
I'm doing 40.
So, what do you wear on a ultra marathon, head to toe? First is this what I'm wearing on my head right here, from Segoy. What is it?
Which is actually a cycling cap that you wear under your helmet, but Norm likes it because it has UVF protection for his
the noggin.
Almost bald head.
Buzz, not bald.
Next.
That's not nighttime.
Oh, daytime.
This is what I wear when I start the race, but when the sun comes out, full cap with neck protection. And all this is UV protection as well, isn't it?
Yep.
I should hide my Zoot. No, we're not getting sponsored by Zoot. But anyway, cool hat. Then we're gonna go down to what I like to wear, another bike jersey, but I like this because of the three pockets in the back. Three pockets, one for nutrition, one for gear, one for miscellaneous, probably mostly garbage, but also full zip because it gets hot, cold, hot, cold. See? So, bike jersey, three pockets in the back, full zip, always wear that. And yes, Canada, wristband, I sweat a lot, and I go through these like crazy. In fact, these are actually hard to find.
They are hard to find nowadays. Old school terry cloth.
This used to be like big in the 70s with tennis, but now constantly doing that. So must have it, only on one wrist, this wrist. The other wrist is my watch, which is the Phoenix 5?
Phoenix 5.
Yeah. I actually ran Switzerland last year and this battery life went 21 hours, which I tried to get under 21 so it wouldn't run out, but I'm gonna hope to do that at Mozart. My goal is under 20, so I don't run out of the battery. Okay. Famous Nathan.
Rob Krar, 7-liter hydration vest. Last year's model.
Which is still good.
It's awesome.
So many things I could do with this vest. I have this pocket here, which is my medical situation here, which carries all kinds of stuff that I have to carry in the race. Otherwise, I would have gone with just a tank top. And then two bottles and nutrition in the front and on the side pockets. I can go over with this vest over and over again, but...
Oh, you got your GoPro hanging out.
Oh, yes. GoPro fits right where my poles will fit. Right in the side back pocket. There you go, Rob Krar vest. That's what I wear.
Did you want to talk about any of your favorite nutrition?
Basically, I'm a real food kind of guy. Peanut butter jam sandwiches, potatoes. Hopefully they are at the aid stations.
Well stocked.
Well stocked.
Not like Switzerland where it had pies. Pies that you had to dig in your own piece. Ew.
No, I do like pies, however.
Not in the middle of a race.
Yes.
Show those poles.
Ugh.
Black diamond, distance, carbon. FLZs.
Yeah.
And we do say Z in Canada.
Not Z.
Not Z.
And I took the bands off. I never wear the band, use the bands, never. So I just take them off, and that also shows the left and right. So I have to put my sticker left, right.
And how much lighter are these than your old Lecky poles?
I don't know, but...
less than half, eh?
Probably.
Mm-hmm. Quick release?
Yeah.
Well, somehow. Not so quick, but...
Oh, there it is. Oh gosh. Yes.
That's it.
In my backpack.
All right.
Oh yes.
Shorts.
I've been starting to wear these funkier shorts because I love these deep pockets on both sides. Why? Nutrition.
Easy access?
Yeah, easy access. It's like, wow. Again, these are bike shorts.
Yes, they are. No chamois, but...
No chamois.
Yeah.
But still, funkier. Deep pockets, Love them. And then over that is a loosely pair of
icebreaker
shorts. Very light. Again, I love my pockets. I got two here and one zip there.
Oh, and you cut the liner out, which is why they work with the the fitted short. Socks.
Got to represent.
Ben Johnson, Canada.
only Canucks will know that. I did Switzerland last year, and I was the only Canadian in the entire race at the, what was it called actually? Scenic 100. And every time I entered an aid station, they saw my Canada, and they went, "Oh, Canada! Oh, Canada!" Love it! There you go. And the compression socks.
Yes, they are. You gonna wear them the entire race?
Don't know.
Okay.
Things happen.
Shoes.
Oh yeah.
Final
shoes. Review. I did a review on these.
Peregrine ISO, which come in wide.
That's why I'm wearing them. However, doing research on the race, there's going to be a lot of pavement, so these may be too aggressive. So I'm going to start with these. I may switch into these. The
Brooks Caldera 3.
Which is not as aggressive, so it can be like, I could probably run the whole race in these. So I will make my decision on race day. There you go. That's what I wear.
That's your gear report.
That's my gear report. And what are you wearing?
Oh, you know, whatever I throw on that day. It's only 40K.
Oh, gosh.
Who's worried?
All right, so we'll see you there, Ultra Tourist, at the... The Ultra Tourist. Tut. Just think Tut. Oh, is that 100? See you there, live and uncensored.